a lot more funner than calling my Ghostbusters.
Hey.
Gabby.
How's it going?
You're live. Good, you're live on the air. Let's welcome Miss Gabi Grecko.
What's up, guys?
Can I tell you how excited I am for this?
Really? That's awesome. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, you're welcome. You know, it's kind of like, as I was going through research and I was saying to my co-host, Nick, the more and more I researched you, the more and more I couldn't wait to talk to you. You were like a firecracker of controversy and beauty rolled into one.
Yes, I've heard things like that. I'm glad that you're excited to talk to me about. Yeah.
Now, it's funny because a mutual friend of ours, the one and only Miss Frenchy, and I know you're part of the Frenchy Mafia.
I am.
She started, I guess, when she was, I guess it was 2 or 3 weeks ago, maybe, or a month ago, there was rumors running rampant that you guys were a couple. And she was hysterical, and she kept sending me all the stories that were popping up all around the world about it.
Yeah, we started kind of dating a few weeks ago, and I guess because I married a 74-year-old guy, I've been nude in the streets, just posed with a dead corpse in a magazine. I've done a lot of crazy stuff, and so has she. So I think it kind of like blew up. That they're like, what the hell is going on with these two?
Yeah, I mean, you really know how to, I guess, ruffle feathers. You want to say? I mean, like you said, you were married to your, you had your, I guess, he's your ex-husband now, who is 74 years old.
We married, yeah, he's 74 years old. We married like 7 months ago, and then we broke up. And we're like separated, but we're still married.
You're still technically married.
Yeah, we're still technically married.
How about I saw there was like a video of him, like a paparazzi was like trying to talk to him, and he was like kind of bad-mouthing.
He was what?
Kind of bad-mouthing you. He was like calling you like mental, and he was saying he's glad that you're out of his hair. And
yeah, I'm like, I don't know, I'm like married to like a 74-year-old child, so I always hear like he's like a girl, like a 74-year-old like gossip girl, like he's always like talking like shit, you know what I mean? I'm just like, what did you say? Like, and then I have to respond. So he's just he's crazy, so I married like another crazy person. But yeah, he's crazy.
Well, how did that whole thing happen? I mean, like, know going into it, like, it was going to be like crazy.
Well, like, I've always kind of, like, you know, been drawn to, like, things that, you know, are a little different, and I'm really open-minded, and sometimes I'm too open-minded. That's what I hear. And my family's like, what the hell? You moved to Australia, now you're marrying this old guy, and, like, what's going on? He's all over the news. Like, who is he? I heard he went to jail. Apparently he tried to kill someone 15 years ago, so he's been in prison. He's been a millionaire like 5 times over. So my family's reading all of this, you know, a year ago, and they're just like, oh my God, Gabby, like, what are you doing? So it kind of...
what was your answer when they would ask you that?
I'm just like, you know, I met him and he seemed, you know, because he's a doctor, or he's deregistered because he went to jail, but he was a doctor, so I'm just like, Mom, Dad, I'm like, you know, he's really smart, he's a really great guy, and they're like, no, we don't think so, and it's like, yeah, well, I'm going to go for it, and, you know, so that was like just one tall, small one small part of my life. But yeah, everyone, I think everyone that knows me is like, what the hell are you doing? Like all the time. So, yeah, it's hard to explain even to myself.
Now, then you, which you also mentioned, I guess you like really, you did a cover for a magazine, and it's called, what's it called? Girls and Corpses?
Girls and Corpses, it just came out. And
yeah.
I talk, it's where you pose, it's like, they say it's like Maxim meets Dawn of the Dead or something. Like, it's like girls and they pose with corpses, not real corpses, but, you know, that's up for discussion. But.
Right. And you're like on the cover, like at a graveyard or a grave plot with a guy that looks just like your husband.
Yeah. So I wanted like some kind of revenge because I'm like, I don't like you anymore. Like, I'm sick of the, you know, all it's like, so I'm like, I talked to the editor. I'm like, hey, I see the girls are posing with corpses on your magazine. And I'm like, my husband is a corpse. Basically. I'm like, I think that we should do like me and my husband, like our, you know, our wedding night, but like he's dead. So basically they dressed up this guy to look like him and made him look dead, and me in like wedding lingerie, and we shot it, and then it shot like all over the UK and Australia where he lives and everywhere. And I have no idea what he thinks about it, but he's probably very pissed off.
So you haven't heard nothing from him then about the cover?
He said, like, I'm immature, but, you know, well, that's okay.
At least it's okay, right?
Yeah. I'm like, he married me, so, you know. That's a big decision. You must kind of like someone. So, yeah, so that's out now. It just came out. So you can still purchase that. It's pretty hilarious, but there's a lot of details about that and, like, other shit, so.
Now, how about you also mentioned, too, like, you took a nude stroll through the streets of Melbourne, Australia. Like, what possessed you to do that?
So it was when I was living with my husband, who is 73, obviously, and I was doing a photo shoot for a magazine called Sneaky Magazine, and we shot all day, and then we ended up getting into some alcohol, and I was really bored, and he's old, so he goes to bed at, like, 7 o'clock. So I was like, let's do something really crazy, and Australia's a lot more conservative, so it was even worse. And it was like the central business district, so it's like really conservative. And yeah, I decided to just like walk straight out of the apartment with like just heels and no clothes on. And I walked all the way down the street, like maybe 3 blocks, and I stopped at Burger King and ordered fast food.
Yeah, what was every, like, I mean, you had to be turning heads everywhere, and everybody had to be, like, in shock. Like,
I was like, it was actually cold, too. So, like, my ass was, like, so cold. Like, it was cold, yeah, and I was, and people were just, like, some people was walking so fast didn't even see me, and the people that did were just so confused. Like, I mean, because, like, even I've never seen a naked person walking down the street, so. It was, and then, like, there's, like, a video. You can actually Google Gabi Grecko walking nude or something like that, and there's a full video of it. And, like, you see when I'm, like, at Burger King, like, the people in line, like, the looks on their faces, and it's just, like, it's, like, really priceless. So when people are, like, do you regret it? I'm, like, no, it was hilarious. Like, it just... I mean, I can wear anything and be confident now. Like, once you walk naked, like, you've kind of done everything, and, like, you're not really scared of what people think. So it's kind of, like, a cool thing.
like your YouTube channel, which I was on, and I was watching a lot of stuff today about you, and I was just like, on your own channel, you put up all the stuff of controversy about yourself, which I was like, wow, look at her. She don't care.
No, it's, some people, write mean comments when they actually like stuff. It just shows they are interesting. That's what I think. So I post stuff about myself. I post, just different, yeah, I post everything, even the mean stuff, yeah.
Now, how about, too, I mean, beside all the controversy, let's put it out there, you are a talented person. I mean, you're a designer, a model, you've done reality TV stuff, you're also a DJ. I mean, you're not just a person that likes to create controversy. So, I mean, like, with the designing, I mean, was that the first thing I think you got into was designing stuff?
I worked like in New York in the garment district with like designers and stuff. So like I did like a lot of fabric stuff, and I just started like learning about it, and you know I really like got into it, and I like styling, and you know a lot of this stuff, basically everything I wear, I don't ever have anyone style me or anything. So if it's not like something controversial I'm wearing, I still like create it. So. That was, like, the first thing. So that kind of, it's just, like, a way to express myself. I like changing it up. Fashion is really fun, you know. It changes all the time.
Now, is that something, like, you're still heavily involved in, or have you gotten away from that, or?
I have, like, a pattern maker who, like, I kind of draw stuff, and they help me make it. I actually make patterns, but sometimes I have other people do it. But I've made mostly corsets. You know those, have you seen those, like, corsets that girls wear to, like, make their waist smaller, like the training corsets? Make those, but I like use different fabrics and stuff. So I've been kind of into that lately. But that's the first thing I started before like all the controversy. And I did like a reality show about like all the club kids in New York. And, you know, like just I've been really heavily, like I'm in New York now. I love New York. I'm from Florida, but like just New York is so busy all the time. It's like nonstop. So it's totally me, and I like it's a great city. I used to live in Harlem, so I started from kind of, you know, a little more humble area.
Right. Now the club kids show you were talking about, I saw a clip on YouTube today with you with that, and it was again controversial.
Yeah, I cheated on my fiance with one of the promoters on the show.
Right.
But my fiance was an asshole, so I kind of like knew that when I did the show and when I like supposedly cheated on him or kissed some guy, and then I started yelling at both of them, and I think I pushed one of them on the show like out of his chair, and he hit his head. So.
Right.
Yeah, there's like a lot of like drama on that show too. I feel like I'm always pushing people. I'm really like not that violent, but like there's like seriously like 8 clips of me like pushing people, but I don't know how to get that out of me. But
I guess people try to push your buttons.
Yeah, they try. I think they do that on TV or something. They like really like try to like piss you off. So yeah, there's like 7 clips of me pushing people. Or, you know, but I don't like pushing people in real life, I don't think.
Well, Ben, you were also on, now this is in Australia, you were on Celebrity Apprentice, and you went on with your husband.
Yes. I went on with my husband, and the first challenge was, we had to sell a whole bunch of crap. Like, we had to sell, like, eels, like, actual eels to the public. Like, no one wants to buy an eel. and like gnomes. Like this is like the first challenge, and like one of the things in the box was a book that was Geoffrey's biography, and he was on the other team, and basically the whole book is like, you know, his entire sex life from like when he was like 12 to like 72. So it's a lot of sex in there. And I'm just like, I hated it. So I like ripped it up on the show. Like I ripped up all the books and like threw it at him. And I threw my ring at him. And I was just like, it's over. I was like, this book is disgusting. So that was like the first episode.
Was there anything in the book about you, or was it before you?
No, it was like before me. So he's been married like two other times and then however many other people have been with. But so it's like all his weddings in the book. I'm just like, this is crap. So I like threw it at him. And I pushed him too. So
not
happening yet. But
don't
I was the first person fired too.
Yeah, you were the first person fired.
Yeah, they brought me back actually because they liked me so much, I guess. But they fired me because I guess I don't have good business skills, whatever.
And,
I think I have great business skills.
How about Geoffrey? How long did he last?
He also was like 4 episodes, but then I came back in like maybe the 3rd episode. So I actually lasted longer than him, but I got to like wait out a few episodes. But you know, it was just like, it's really business oriented. And like, I'm totally like the opposite of business. So just every day was like a huge struggle being on that show. It's probably the worst show I could have been casted on, to be honest.
Wow.
Because I'm not like a chair, like a desk person.
Would you do reality TV again?
Yeah, definitely. Just like something more relaxed, where you know I don't have to like be on time every day and.
Where you have to work.
Well, working is fine, but like that, I'm more out of the box, and it's just, I don't know. I did horrible, like all the challenges. I was just like the worst, whether I tried my hardest or not. So I think I'm just a really bad businesswoman. So something like that. Yeah, no work is better. Yeah. We'll just go with that.
And how about it? You were also, you did Penthouse, Maxim.
Yeah, I did actually the Penthouse 50th anniversary, which is like really cool. It was like a double cover.
That's huge.
And like one side was like, they let me do like basically be the creative director for one side of the cover, and I did like 60.
Oh, cool.
So it has, like, roller skates, and it looks kind of like the classic, like, Penthouse covers that they used to have. And so it's really tight. And the other one is just, the other cover is just sexy, kind of, you know, like a wet shirt or something like that. But, yeah, and I have, like, there's a Twister spread in there, like a nude spread where I'm playing Twister. There's a few interesting things in there, so I should really check that out.
Already a step ahead of you.
Already have? Check it out again.
Okie dokie. You got any other good things coming up, or what are you working on now?
I'm looking at some, like, different networks for some reality. I'm actually also, do not ask me to rap, but I'm working on writing a rap and doing a video. And what else am I doing?
Are you going to try to follow in Frenchy's footsteps?
Hers is like, I think, is her singing or rapping? I think this is a combination. Mine will be like a little more like gangster, but not. but because I can't sing at all, so it won't be singing. But I'm gonna like be creative director of the video and kind of, you know, try to do something cool like New York sites, wherever
cool.
They give me a permit.
Oh boy.
I know, New York's like, you know, you can't shoot, like, the Statue of Liberty, like, it's, you know, we own that. It's really, it's hard in New York to shoot, but, yeah, I'm going to try to get
really?
Cool New York. Yeah, you have to get permits for just everything, but, because it's where they film, like, Spider-Man, and, I don't know, like, just everything. They film a lot of stuff here.
Right.
Law and Order is being filmed, like, every day here. So
right.
The streets are closed off a lot of the time.
Huh.
But,
now, how about DJing? You still doing the whole DJ thing, or?
Yeah, I'm going to try to, I live, like, in basically the meatpacking district. That's where, like, all the clubs are. So it's really easy to get, like, gigs here because I'm always here. So I'll definitely be doing some of that, and I hope to be making, like, the beats for the video that I put out, so I can kind of, like, because I kind of like doing behind-the-scenes stuff, kind of creating, so it's
nice.
Fun. I just like being around creative people and churning out different ideas. They don't always work, but, you know, I try.
But it's fun to create.
Yeah. It's like a release from all the stress, you know, every day, just kind of like putting some stuff out there yourself. So I really enjoy it.
Cool. And is there any more 74-year-old men in your future, or?
That's way too young. I'm going
to
I'm going to shoot for a little older. No, I don't know. I think, you know, I'm just, I'll date Frenchy, you know, and then if we don't get married, then I'll figure it out. I have a cat.
I think that would be
like
awesome.
Enough for, if we got married.
Oh, yeah. Come on, you got to.
I know. That would be, oh, man, like a huge explosion. But very entertaining. We need our own show. We're like, we don't have our own
show,
but like, what is it?
Now, here, look at this. I'm going to plan it down for you because you know what? On because this is my network, right? And on the network, I have this other show, and it's called Big Daddy's Hard Talk. And he was just announcing the other day on his show that like he's kind of like a minister. And his friends came to him recently and asked him to marry them. So I can get Big Daddy to marry you guys, and we can do it all on the show.
Oh, my God, that would be so cool. Yeah, and imagine what kind of wedding we would have.
We got to get this going.
It'd be like I'd be nude and she'd be like singing Frenchy Mafia and, you know, who knows what else. Something like that. I don't know if he'd get married in a church with all that, but.
Yeah, I don't think it would be a church. I definitely don't think it would be a church wedding.
Yeah. We're more progressive, though, so that's okay.
It'd be more like, I think, a nude beach or something.
Yeah, we got to move ahead, stay ahead of the times. It'll be like that in 20 years anyway. So.
Nice.
I think rebelling
you know,
is just part of progress.
So I see the headlines now. Frenchy and Gabi getting married in the nude.
Exactly. How'd you know?
See that?
But, yeah.
You know what? See, I'm going to send that out to the press after this, and I'm going to see what they say.
You should, because no one's done that, and we would honestly be the ones to do that, to be honest.
So is there, like, a real relationship between you guys, or is it just fun?
We're like dating, but we're friends too. We're not in like a committed relationship because I live in New York and she's in LA, so I go like back and forth.
Right.
But
huh.
The future, I don't know. It might be more serious, so it's kind of exciting, but it would be a nude wedding. I've decided just now, for sure.
Look at that. We're wedding.
Because I think we could both be confident to do that.
Can you imagine Geoffrey's head be spinning off his body right now?
Yeah, he would have a heart attack. But if he lives to see the wedding, yes. Yeah, he'll die. He'll definitely die. But, you know, me and Frenchy, I think, will top, you know, any wedding, you know, in some bizarre way. Not traditional, but the nude wedding, I love
awesome.
It. I love it.
Yeah, there you go. It's been decided. Very good. This is exciting. We're going to be a part of a wedding. I like it.
You can marry us.
There you go. Look, Big Daddy just lost his spot. I'm going to do it now.
Oh, yeah, he's okay. So you want to be the flower girl?
Can I be the best man? I'll be the best man for both of you.
Yeah, exactly. We don't have anyone.
No offense to you guys out there,
but we don't have one.
I'll give you to her. Or give her to
yes.
You.
Okay. And then Big Daddy
there
will do
go.
Will do
the
will do the regards. Yeah. I see it.
How about
perfect.
Now I have two co-hosts here that are very quiet. They're probably in shock right now. We gotta find something for Nick to do and Jeanette to do. So what can you guys do?
I'll be the flower girl. I'm cool with it.
Yeah, the flower girl. Because I think we should just switch all the roles. You know, maybe we'll have one of those little kids be the best man. You guys will be the flower girls. And then the usher will be someone we don't know, I guess, or a cousin, a weird cousin.
We'll need something for the weird cousin to do. I know Jeanette would be the usher. He won't be the flower girl. I know that.
The usher?
Yeah, he'll be the usher.
I don't know. I would not want to be the usher, like, escorting people to their seats. I would just be like, sit wherever you want.
Now, which would you be considered? Would you be considered the bride or the groom? Or is it just two brides? I mean, how does that technically, legally, would it work?
I feel like that would be like a big power struggle there, too. Because me and Frenchy are both like really dominant personalities. So I guess it would be.
I mean, you're
like,
already starting your first fight. You can't do this now.
God. Yeah, you're right. Well, I could just let her win and say I really don't agree deep down, but go ahead.
There you go.
Our first compromise. You've already helped us. We don't need counseling now.
See that? That's what makes good relationships is compromise. Very good.
I know when to step down. Like, I don't feel like fighting right now. But, yeah. Frenchie's great, but she's very strong-willed and has a lot to say, too. So, I love her.
Wow. Should be interesting. Should be very, very interesting.
is everyone like, what the hell is going
on? Are you going to be the one to tell Frenchy all this, or should I tell her? How are we going to do this?
You should tell her, you know, that I made it official. She'll be like, what? Like, what did she do? She said we're getting married? She's like, Gabby.
How did you meet Frenchy?
What did you do again? So I was like, Gabby, what did you say? Why did you say that? I'm just like, I don't know. It just felt like the right thing. We met actually, how did we meet? I think we met through like we have the same agent. So I think I came across her on social media, and I was just like, oh my God, she looks so fun. We agreed to meet up. I didn't know if we'd actually get along or not, but we became, like, really close really fast. So sometimes the internet brings you creepy-ass people, and sometimes it brings you cool people, like Frenchy. So, you know, it wasn't like a fishbowl or what's that called? Catfish? Goldfish?
Right, right, right.
Something
catfish,
like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't like that. That was my first marriage,
through...
catfish.
Oh, lovely. Wait, how many times have you been married?
Wait, well, once, but that's not working.
Oh, okay.
So now I'm like, okay, I'm in number two, basically. One, yeah.
Well, number two will be the successful one.
Yeah, will be the nude wedding.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, see, I met Frenchy through social media and been trying to get her to come on the show, and we've booked multiple dates, but she's always so busy, and she's always like, here, have Gabby on. Here, have this person on. Here, have Sham on. And you know, I'm getting all these friends of hers, and you guys are all like a trip. And then she'll message me and be like, hey, let's set a date. And we set the date, and she's like, okay. And then it's like, here's Gabby's phone number. Text her right now. I'm like, okay.
That's hilarious because. Oh, man. She would. I'll relay the message to her that you would like to actually set a date before death.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's funny
to,
that...
You have to do it before death.
Yeah, I know, like, sometime. I'll tell her that, like, that you would, like, maybe like to schedule a real date. I'll get her. Maybe we can do, like, a conference.
You know,
that would be a huge trip.
See, I wanted to get her. See, now, here's what I'm going to do. When I get her on the show, oh, look, that Big Daddy is... Will we try to get Big Daddy on the phone right now?
Yes.
Okay, hold on. Let me message him real quick.
So I can say, like, my part of the vows, and then you just send her a text and ask her to say I do. And say, by the way, you're married now, Frenchy.
Hold on. Look, I think Big Daddy's going to call it.
Like an instant message wedding.
Okay. Big Daddy's going to call it.
Now, see, babe, that's interesting. She said an instant message wedding, but what about maybe a Twitter wedding?
Ah.
There you go. Ooh. Because
we have followers, so they're kind of like guests.
Yeah.
Right. Then you can invite everybody to attend via Twitter. And then you get all that interaction. You start to get trending.
Yeah.
See?
So I need to send out, like, a wedding invitation for a few minutes from now. No, for when the wedding is, and then have them, like, stream it somehow. Okay, I can see that. More people would come than...
Wait,
use the hashtag.
My buddy's got a video production company. I'm going to get this all set up. Hold on. Now... Big Daddy, you're live on the air here. How you doing, buddy?
What's going on, man? How you doing?
I'm doing good.
Hey.
You're about to look. I want you to meet our new friend. This is she's a model. She's been in Penthouse, Maxim. She's a true piece of work. Her name is Gabi Grecko.
Okay. Hey, Gabi.
What's up?
Okay.
What's up?
Now, she's in the midst of going through a divorce from her 74-year-old husband, but she's getting ready.
74-year-old husband.
Just 74-year-old husband. Now, we've decided that she and her girlfriend, another friend of ours who's Frenchy, she decided that her and Frenchy are going to get married in the nude. Now, I heard you on your show the other day talking that you were going to marry your friend. And I wanted to know if you would perform the ceremony for them.
if I could steal a line from my man Steve Austin, oh hell yeah!
Yay! Yeah. It's on.
There you go. I got it.
Here's the thing.
For you.
Here's the thing. You would have to go to City Hall to actually have it done. You know, with the paperwork and everything, but I could do the ceremony, yes.
We just need the ceremony. It doesn't have to be legal.
Yeah. It's going to be a Twitter wedding.
Would I be a bigamist?
No, you'd be all right.
If we could do the ceremony, like, real low-key, you know, like, say,
for, like,
you know,
3 million Twitter followers.
Yeah, like,
we're going to put it on, like, it's going to be the first social media wedding. Imagine that.
Yeah, really? Low-key, it'll be on Australian TMZ.
Exactly.
you guys can, how about this? You guys can Snapchat it back and forth to each other.
Yeah, we got to, like, stream this somehow. I know we can get a lot of people to watch it just because they'll be like, what the? They'll be like, not again.
We could break the internet with this. Imagine that.
Yeah,
I think you're right. I'd be glad
to
be with it.
You guys are in LA, right?
No, I'm in Philly.
Wait, where? Okay, so is that where the wedding will be? We're going to do it online and then just stream it from all ends. And kind of...
Yeah, we'll figure it out. Location is technicalities. We'll figure it out.
All right. Well, let's get married. I'm ready for my second marriage already.
Now, you guys might want to just run the idea by Frenchy first. I mean, just like...
I was going to say, she's going to be the last to know.
She doesn't need to know.
I know. We're planning all this stuff, and she doesn't even know.
So?
Look. Now, who's going to...
We're getting married.
Do you want me to tell her for you, or are you going to tell
her?
Yeah, you
tell her, because I want to hear her response to me. She'll be like, what the hell?
What is she doing? What is she doing now? She's doing something now, because this is supposed to be her time slot, or I say we call her.
Yeah, should we try to call her?
I don't know. You tell me.
Yes, definitely. I think you should. With that,
yeah.
Try calling her. Call her.
Because it's her wedding too. It's my wedding.
You know what, though? In all seriousness, this will really teach Frenchy to give out other people's phone numbers.
You're like, here, bitches. This is what happens when you put your friends on the show.
I heard her number on my phone.
I give it to you, but then I give it to everyone, so maybe not.
Yeah.
The worst thing is if we don't get a hold of her, we can send her the marriage certificate in a tweet and let her know what happened when she wasn't on air.
I'll tell you what, I'm gonna put you on hold and I'm gonna get the number from you. Can we do that?
Yeah.
All right, hold on.
All right.
Yeah, these are crazy. Big Eddie, you still there?
I'm still here.
So what's going on your show this week?
I'm trying to get Christian Cosby to call in because he has really been all over the place. He's covered a bunch of parties and stuff with the NBA. And especially with the draft lottery coming up, the next day. I wanted to have a little talk about that, and plus I wanted to get my buddy from the Daily News, Keith Popoli, to call in so he can give his opinion about the draft and what the Sixers need and this, that, and the fourth. And outside of that, I'm going to, ask a bunch of relationship questions and piss a bunch of women off and talk a bunch of trash.
Awesome.
That's my
favorite
part of the show.
As many women off as possible. That's my favorite thing.
Because,
all right.
Somebody got to keep these women straight.
Okay.
Oh, boy. All right, here we go.
Answer.
Hi, it's Angelique. I'm not available at the moment, so please give me a voice now. And I'll call you back as soon as I can.
Gabi, leave her a message.
So, advice, please do text me. Thank you. Bonjour, c'est Angelique. Je suis à disponible pour le moment et c'est moi un message pour une réponse immédiate à vos emails. Merci.
At the tone, please record your message.
All right.
When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
Hey, Frenchy, I just wanted to call you to ask you if you would marry me. I just wanted to say I called for your permission. If not, that's okay. We're going to go through with it on the air now. But when you get this message, you'll see the updates about our wedding coming up. Should have answered the phone. I love you. Bye. She'll get that message.
Oh, that's funny. That is funny. And on a related note,
she didn't answer. That's her fault.
And on a related note, getting Gabi to set a time for a guest spot is probably out too.
Yeah.
Oh, this is classic.
See, you didn't know what you were getting yourself into when you decided to do this show, huh?
I didn't know I was going to get married, but, easy enough.
And you know what? You're welcome. How about that? I planned out your whole marriage, your new successful marriage.
I know. I needed someone to, plan out something successful. So, even if it lasted just a little bit, then that's okay.
Now,
I don't think it'll last forever.
When will your other marriage become officially done?
That one. God, if I listen to myself after this, I think 6 months or something.
Wow.
But I can have a ceremony, right?
Yeah. That's all.
Has anyone been married, divorced, or not divorced and tried to have a ceremony?
I've been married and divorced, but it was
you didn't
a couple
try to
years
have a
between...
ceremony during the wedding.
No, it was years between, marriages or whatever. So.
Well, some people do it during, I guess. People do. we'll find out the technicalities, but. I'm
no,
going to give you the green light.
When you made that proposal, were you down on your knee? You should have told her, I'm down on my knee making my proposal for you.
Oh, my God.
But that would make me the masculine one. Aren't I supposed to be like...
That's right.
I follow advice. I got to let her propose so that she's in control. But...
I don't think you can let her propose if she doesn't know about the wedding.
It's all fuzzy details. It all works out in the end. All that matters is that we become happily married in the nude. Can we make this happen soon?
See that? Making dreams come
true
around the world.
Absolutely.
That's what we do here.
We'll figure out whether it's going to be... streaming online or in person. Either way, And then, but it just has to be two naked bodies. You know, we have to both be nude. So.
Now, how's that for you, Big Daddy?
A fake Chuck. That's cool with me. I'll just remind you, you being a fake Chuck Warring right now.
No, I would personally like to say that I would like the guests to be nude, too. Would you guys be open to that?
No, that's what I was going to ask. What about the wedding party? Can the wedding party be clothing optional?
Because I feel like we should all be nude. Then, like,
I'll give you guys a few months.
You know, we can all go to the gym for a little bit.
We need years to go to the gym.
Right.
Yeah. So I think we should tone up a little bit. We need to wear like togas. I think we would look good in togas.
Clearly, she's never seen us.
No.
Why do I?
No.
I'm ready. I can't wait.
Yeah. No.
I'm Googling you now. I'm like, wait a second.
No.
No, I'm ready.
No. Since you're Googling people, Google Six's Big Daddy, and then you'll reconsider what you just said, what you see the pictures of me. So
you'll
reconsider the whole thing. Google Six's Big Daddy. And you'll
What's
see
the
if all the pictures
word?
Come up. Sixers.
Six.
As in the 76ers.
Are you a
Sixers?
Basketball fan?
Not
you like
enough
NBA
to
basketball?
Know about it.
Okay.
I like the Yankees.
The Yankees is baseball. How about the Philadelphia 76ers?
First you said basketball, then you said baseball.
Nah.
I can't
it's
keep
basketball.
Up with all these sports.
The Philadelphia 76ers. Type in Sixers. S-I-X-E-R-S.
Oh, Sixers Big Daddy. Got it. There we go.
So once you see that, you won't want...
I'm ready.
Your mind about that.
Perfect.
Now, do you want him to have the wig on, too, or...
I don't know. Should we keep it natural? I think orange wig here. If you could wear the orange wig, it's like red.
Well,
do you still have that, Big Daddy?
I still got that one. I still have it. I can wear that.
that's what I like, actually. That'll match me.
Nice.
I like the blonde, though, too, man. I like that you wear wigs. So do I. We are so similar.
Yeah, I'm not bad.
Wig and clothes, though.
Yeah, like, what color wig have you worn recently? Like, I've seen you with, like, orange and purple and...
I like wearing... orange a lot. Just because, like, I don't know. It's a fun color. I want orange a lot, I think. Yeah.
Now, since you like orange, I'm going to ask this. Have you ever been a Hooters girl?
No, actually.
Wow. Okay.
And I really like orange, which, you know, is sad. I can always go back and do that. Like, you know.
Yeah, here you go.
Just in case.
Nice.
I'm not good, you know, in restaurants, so. I can't cook.
How about... So we need to... Once Frenchy finds out she's getting married, we'll need to pull all this together.
Well, send me the press releases and the invitations if you like to make them, but I will volunteer to make them. If not, I don't know.
Invitations?
On Twitter, right?
Make up a Facebook event and send out the invite. There you go.
oh, I'll make like a Facebook Frenchy and Gabby's wedding, and people can just add if they're coming.
Hey Nick, can you do some graphics for like Nick and Gabby's Gabby's and Frenchy's wedding?
Yeah.
And put like two cartoon girls, one with blonde hair, one with orange hair, and they're naked.
Yes.
And it'll be like,
yes.
You have to be nude, cartoons, and then, you know, getting married in the bus or something like that.
I got you.
And maybe she'll stumble upon it. And then I'll have to explain later what that was about. But
I think she'll be plenty fine with it.
Yeah, me too.
Now, will you still be bi-coastal?
Yeah, I used to live like in Venice, back and forth from Venice to, you know, Venice, California to Manhattan for a little while. So it just gets a little slow in LA sometimes. Like, obviously compared to New York, it's like quiet.
Right.
Yeah. Like here, like where I stay, like all night, I hear like fire trucks and police and people yelling and just like all kinds of shit. But I like it. I like kind of being in the life of the city, basically. There's a NY.
Now, I just want to say, like, for some crazy reason, I don't see it happening, but just like, you know, in case the marriage doesn't work out and you and Frenchy sadly decide to go your separate ways, would you do another Girls and Corpses video or a cover shoot with now Frenchy's corpse?
Usually the corpse is a guy.
Doesn't always have to be.
Yeah, but remember, right, we're breaking barriers here, remember?
Oh, my God, maybe we need a new thing. Maybe we need to ask Girls and Corpses if they'll do, like, a lesbian, you know.
Right.
That will be, like, a transitional thing.
Yeah.
You know, like, they're coming into, like, the new. You're right. Yeah. They would totally be on board. I mean, I have to ask them obviously, but like their magazine is awesome. The owner is Robert Ryan, and he lives in LA. He drives a hearse for his actual car. So he's pretty open minded. He drives, like, a big hearse, and it says Girls and Corpses on the back of it.
Too funny.
Yeah. It's pretty great.
Yeah.
So,
we're plotting out, like,
you
the whole...
You should get him on your show, actually.
See, now, look, you're referring people to us.
Oh, man. I'm becoming, like,
crunchy. Oh, man.
But, yeah.
I think we should have you come back on every
awesome.
Week.
I would
we
love
just have
to
Gabby
that.
Come.
Yeah, and like I can unify people, marry them when they didn't know they were going to get married. We can like set up people.
There you go. We can do like Gabby's love connection.
Yeah, I love it. I think, or we can like.
Now,
call
here's
our exes from like high school or something.
Yeah. Too bad I can't call out of the country. I said we call your ex husband.
Oh yeah, we can still make that happen if it's like on Australian time somehow.
Yeah, but my studio doesn't call out of the country. That's the problem. Unless you call
them
on freeway.
Yeah, that won't work then. Their numbers are like 14 digits long, I think, or something. It's like insane memorizing a number from there. I don't know why they even do that, but yeah, their Australian numbers are so long.
So if you had to set up your ex-husband with somebody, who would you set him up with?
I don't know, someone like really annoying that would drive him crazy, probably.
Gabi Grecko, you are a firecracker, my dear.
Thank you very much, I think.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Well, anything you want to, let's plug your, you got to plug all your social media stuff. Where can everybody find you? Where can they send wedding gifts? Now, you have to put together like an Amazon wish list, and we can send it out to everybody so they can buy you guys the wedding presents.
Like 7,000 pairs of shoes. So my Instagram is @GabiGrecko. My name is spelled wrong a lot, but it's Grecko with a K. So if you kind of spell it like G-A-B-I, Gabi, and then Grecko with a K, I should come up. And my nude walk, if you Google Gabi Grecko nude walk, that should come up, and you should see a girl with green hair walking down the street.
Wait a minute. Is there an uncensored version?
Yeah.
Really? I only saw the censored version. Hold on.
It's on, if you Google Gabi Grecko nude walk sneaky, I think, because that's the magazine. I know that they have the actual one on their site.
SneakyMag.com. Not safe for work. Do you like that? Do you like that? When your name pops up next to not safe for work?
If it was porn, I wouldn't like it, but I know it's not.
You haven't done porn,
I call it art.
You call porn art or your nude walk
art? No, the walk art. Porn is porn. I can tell sort of the difference, but no, it's like it can't be on YouTube. It was banned from so many sites before they actually like streamed it. I think it's streamed through a porn space stream, but it's not porn.
Right. My computer's, come on. You're breaking my computer here.
Exactly. It's on kind of I'm looking on my, it's like the first slide that comes up. And there's a darling picture, me and my ex in his ill-fitted suit.
Look at that outfit. I like
the nude or the outfit?
Both, but that was it too. Like, what was the deal? You went to somebody's funeral and you wore like this real exposing dress.
It was black though.
Well, yeah. At least you were wearing clothes to mourn. Look at you just walking down the street.
Yeah, it's there. And sometimes I watch it and it'll say like 12 people watching. And I'm just like, oh my God, that's weird.
Taking an elevator. Now, who was filming this?
It was a sneaky magazine. It's like a big Australian like art magazine and it's a really controversial magazine. They just pick like really, really cool like kind of just off-color topics like each magazine.
Now, is this like in a mall or something?
It's like the the complex for the building that I lived in that I'm first in, and I'm like going up the elevator with like a veil,
right,
but like nude, and it like getting stuck, I think, and then I like go back down, but no.
Oh,
it
now you're
wasn't.
Going right out onto the street. Look at this Oriental guy. He at ATM. He just blew his mind. You're just right out in the street with bunny ears now. You don't care.
Yeah, and you're gonna see. It's not called Burger King there. It's called, I don't know, some copyright issue. They have a different name, but it's the same thing. What's it called? But that's the place I go into.
Now, whose idea was this? Was this your idea to do, or did they approach you with the idea?
That was my idea. It was on the news for a while, but obviously it was censored.
Now, what did Geoffrey say about this?
He's actually mad. I told him, like, you know, it's my life. Like, if I needed to do it. Because, like, after I walked nude, I really, like I said, I wasn't, like, really afraid of anything. And every, you know, like, it's kind of just like, okay. Well, I mean, obviously I'm afraid of things, but it just put things into a little bit. Like, I thought I'd be a lot more scared walking nude. I thought I would be, like, terrified. But I really, for some reason, didn't care. And I had had a drink or two, but I knew it wasn't just that. You know, I, like, really didn't care that I was, like, on the street nude. So it was kind of, like, empowering. Well, it kind of felt really cool.
You can tell,
I,
like,
I honestly
recommend
to do it one time. I wouldn't recommend to keep doing it. But, like, one time is really cool.
I mean, you can tell as it's going on, the more you're doing it, the more confident you're getting doing it.
Yeah, it's just like at first I was just like, oh, my God, I'm going to pretend like I'm not scared. And then after a while I was just like, wow, I'm not scared. So, yeah, so and they kind of like, because some people were complaining, not people that actually saw me, but, like, just people that found out about it in the media and stuff like that. And they're like, how come, you know, she's not getting in trouble? Is because she's, you know, famous there, or is because, you know, so I actually had to go to court and, you know, say that I was sorry. But, you know, I wasn't really sorry. You know, I actually, like, don't regret doing it. You know, they had to, like, put me through, like, a proper process, you know, this is not right, you know, or whatever. But, you know, I'd do it again for the first time.
Huh. That is crazy. I can't believe you did that. Now, did you get arrested when doing this, or?
No, I shot the whole video and went back up to the apartment, and then we uploaded it, like, that same night, and it got taken off, like, every site that we uploaded it until we found, like, one that would take it, and then it was on the Australian news for, like, weeks and weeks and weeks, and then, like, I had... people were, like, complaining, so the police had to eventually call me in, and they said, hey, we're getting a lot of complaints, so basically we have to talk to you, or they think that we're giving you a free pass or some blah, 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 blah. So I had to give a statement and then go to court and pay a fine for doing that. But I think it was just kind of, like, because they were, like, okay, because there's, like, people – there's jealous people, there's people that just don't like you, people that think you're trashy, people, you know, different things they thought about me doing that, you know, that, you know, they're like, how come she's getting away with it or whatever, but they weren't, you know, very hard on me about it. Like, I think they just kind of had to, like, because they were getting they're getting tons of calls, I guess. People have nothing better to do.
uh, Gabby. All right, well, I guess, again, the plug's out there. And start getting prepared for your wedding. And we're going to pull that together for you.
I'm going to need to talk to you guys soon.
Yeah. Now Frenchie's coming on June 2nd. So I'll keep in touch with you, but I'm going to call you while we have Frenchie.
Okay. Awesome.
So this way we can talk more about this. Okay?
Yeah, just keep in close touch, and I'm here. So I'm really excited.
Nice. I'm excited, too. This will be our first marriage. Bringing
perfect
love together on Totally General Radio. I can't wait.
All right. Well, have a fantastic night, and thank you guys for talking to me. It made my night together. Awesome.
Cool. It's been fun, Gabby. It's been a lot of fun.
All right. Have a good night.
You too. Take care.
Bye.
Bye. I mean, there she goes. There is no other. She is the one and only Gabby Grecko.
And you forgot to get her to cut an ID.
I'm pretty sure
you're going to hear a lot from Gabby in the future. And let me just put it out there for you. After hearing this, I don't think that date for Frenchy is going to be firm.
Oh,
just
boy.
Just going to leave that right there for you.
Wow.
And if your head wasn't so wrapped around something, you would have remembered the ID.
Nah, actually, I did remember. I'll tell you why I didn't.
I
figured
that his head's wrapped around.
Well, actually,
I'm confused. I don't know what it is. I'd just like you to say it.
No.
No?